Okay, here we have the Electrolux Magic Mill Assistant Mixer, and I previously tried to make challah and I did just about everything wrong, so now I'm going to try to do everything right. I've watched the instructions from Bread Beckers and I think I can do this better now. Okay, so we start with warm water. This is a double batch of sandwich bread. Not challah, there's no eggs in this, so it won't put up as big of a fight. And they said you put the yeast in later, and you were putting the sweeteners and everything in first, which I'm not going to do. So how am I going to do this? Yeah, I'll put the... Well, I'll put... You should put in about half, and... I did my double batch by putting one in each bowl. They had the machine turned on by now. I guess I should do that part. Dump a whole bowl in there. You cannot do that on a KitchenAid. And she said, knead on high. Now the manual from the manufacturer does not say knead on high. It says knead on low. She's saying knead on high, so I'll do that. And she said that the dough will look wet and that you... to see if it pulls away as soon as you quickly after you should pull away from the sides quickly after you push it toward the center. Let's see if it does that. keep this in place. So, I'm going to do my little test about does it want to come away from the side. And it seems that it does. I think I'll hold off on my flour here. I'm going to let it knead for 10 minutes. For 10 minutes, so you will poop out sometime before then. It's sticky. It's not climbing up over this. That's what my challah dough did. But it was a triple batch of challah, and this is a double batch of, well, that was 20 cups of flour, and this is 18. No, 16. Except one of it's still here, so it's 15. Makes three loaves, so that is six loaves of bread in there. Okay, we are recording again, and now I took out the guide or scraper. Any restriction on it. before we started kneading. I don't know what it's supposed to do now. Well, let's just let her go. You turn on your oven for like 200 degrees for just a couple minutes to make it a warm spot, and then you put your dough in there to rise. This is what happened. Talk about doubling in size. It's only been in there about half an hour. That is some seriously doubled dough. This is a 12-quart bowl. Man. Okay, well, the yeast certainly is happy. The camera's probably going to fill up soon. Okay, it's dry to the touch. And it's sticky on the walls. This is very dry, which means that stuff hasn't been moving. This is all sticky, which means he hasn't been getting kneaded. Man! I've had it with this. Okay, I put the scraper back in, so that way it'll always have to come away from the sides.